Kite flying, a centuries-old art, is on the wane in Malaysia. That's because there are very few craftsmen who still have the traditional knowledge of kite making and are passing down that knowledge to the next generation. But Shefi Jozo is one of the few remaining kite makers who want to do their bit to keep the craft alive.
The art of making traditional Malaysian kites is a unique and an intricate process. A process fine-tuned and passed on through generations. The ancient skills take a long time to perfect. Shefi Jozo is one such kite maker from Kelantan who simply loves this art and has been perfecting it for more than 50 years.
I stopped by schooling because I was fond of kite making. When I see a kite flying high in the air, my heart is even happier.
The kites are made in many shapes, mostly inspired by animals like stingrays, cats and peacocks. The Wau Bulan, a moon kite, is a popular design and a national symbol. The tip resembles a crescent, an art which needs daily practice. Kite making needs a lot of patience. It takes around a week or two to make a small kite, while a kite as high as 3 meters with intricate design takes months. The art, some fear, is on the decline, and there are a few takers who have the passion or patience to become an expert.
It takes many, many years to learn the craft and to master the craft. And the situation in Kelantan now, as elsewhere in Malaysia, is that there are very few craftsmen who still have this traditional knowledge and are passing down this traditional knowledge to the next generation.
69-year-old Shefi Jozo is one of the few remaining kite makers who had dedicated their lives to this age-old craft, which he now aims to pass on to future generations. He wants to impart the knowledge to them and the skills so that others can keep kites flying.